What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel for another video. I got a pretty quick one here on the new BIOS 322 that came out July 4th for the ROG Ally, and also the Army Crate SE update went live for me at about 10:30 last night, earlier than the scheduled July 5th. So it's been almost 24 hours at time making this video that I've been updated and checking things out, so I thought I would make a little video. But let's first go take a look at the notes here really quickly. So for BIOS 322, there's a bug fix that resolved an issue with boot loop for BIOS passwords that were set. And they also modified the Ally's fan curve from 30 dBA to 35 in turbo mode when plugged in, and from 25 dBA to 30 when in turbo mode when on battery. This will help with some temperatures and things like that. I know they're also battling the SD card issues. I don't know if this will have anything to do with that. I'm not noticing anything major. You can hear the fans a little bit more, but honestly, this device is really quiet for a handheld as it is. As far as Armory Crate SE update, we've got the 1.2.13 update for July 5th here. The UX improvements are optimizing the panel's opacity, resulting in a better balanced display. We have a new feature with modified FPS limiter for 30, 45, 60, 90, 120. We'll take a look at that as well in the video. We have added BIOS and Armory Crate configuration information to your system settings. They have a bug fix for the incorrect TDP values being displayed in manual mode. This is a big one for me, not having proper TDP values when making a custom setup. So that's a good one. Resolved an issue when uploading images to social media. There's a bug fix that resolved issues for Armory Crate code displaying. I believe this is the one that when you would shut down the PC, it would show this error code every time for Armory Crate, because I don't get that anymore. So that's a really good one as well. And then added an Alt F4 function in the command center to quickly exit game. So we'll take a look at a lot of this in action, but just want to go over those notes really quickly there with you. So getting over back onto the Ally here, this update actually has been pretty nice for me, and gaming performance seems to be pretty much the same for me. If you go in here and check in your MyASUS, you can check for your essential updates, and you'll see the new July 4th BIOS update in there. Either you'll have it installed or you'll still need to install it. I haven't run into any bugs or problems with this one, and again, for me, gaming performance is relatively similar. The big thing for me is just how fast the Armory Crate software works now and Command Center. It's super snappy going back and forth, as to where before for me, both of these were just very laggy. I also had this random thing where the keyboard would just pop up for a few seconds all the time going back and forth. That doesn't happen anymore. This quality of life improvement for just how snappy everything is now definitely makes a nicer experience here on the ROG Ally. It's definitely something that I noticed first. Now, going into the operating mode and settings, we'll go over to manual. This is where you can set up your own TDP and all that kind of stuff. You got different sections here for your regular standard TDP, your boost options, your fan curves and all that. And then, of course, you can name it as well. And what would happen is when you go into Command Center, it wouldn't show you the proper value. So now I'll go ahead and go in here and I'll go to my manual 18. And now when I select it, it's actually going to show 18 instead of 15. It used to just say manual 15. It was annoying as you would cycle through a bunch of them. Hopefully you can see it here. Apologize for the camera work there, but it's on 18 manual now. You should be able to catch a glimpse of it there. But this is super handy when you have a bunch to go through and scroll through and you're just not trying to guess or look over at your overlay to see. So for me, this little fix is a big quality of life, as long as along with all the snappy stuff. Now this end task thing, or the Alt F4, is really useful. Over here in settings, you can see the edit command center, and they've added that into an automatic option. So if you go into your menu here, you can add it into Command Center, which I've already done. Allows you to pretty much exit any application that's open behind you there. So we'll go in here, say I have something like Google Chrome open. I can just scroll down here to end task and click on it, and Google Chrome will be gone. Of course, there are shortcut keys you can use as well, but I just want to show it off in Command Center there. But all in all, this update for me has just been a really nice quality of life improvement for the ROG, and hasn't seemingly introduced any problems for me. Now you can, of course, check the Update Center in Armory Crate. Make sure that not only your BIOS is updated, but your Armory Crate software as well, in case it doesn't automatically pop up for you. But yeah, again, this has been a decent BIOS and Armory Crate update for me, and I hope to see ASUS continue along this path. The FPS limiter, another one in here I did want to show really quick, 30, 45, 60, 90, 120. I'd like to see them tweak that to where we could have a manual setting and add to that. That would just really top that off for me if we were able to do that eventually. But yeah, anyways, pretty good update for them there. I hope ASUS keeps this up as they keep polishing the ROG Ally. the experience does continue to get better, and it has become the device I grab the most to handheld game on, which says a lot. Its weight, its balance, its performance. Yeah, it has some clunky issues that they're working through, but they are working through it, so I hope we continue to see those updates. When the Steam Deck first launched, it was a little rough in the beginning too, and its experience now is much better than it was at launch, and I absolutely love the Steam Deck as well. These handhelds really are going places, and I'm excited to see what happens over the next few years with them. But anyways, guys, I just wanted to kind of go over this update with Armory Crate and with the BIOS and let you know I haven't had any trouble yet, and the quality of life improvements are definitely really nice here on the Ally. All right, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.